This is Rothamsted Research, the world's oldest agricultural research centre. But have you ever wondered, what do they do here? Let's catch you up on what we've been doing for the past 180 years. It all started in 1843, where our founder, Sir John Lawes, became interested in producing better crops. His homemade experiments at the manor, such as growing cabbages in his bedroom and dissolving bones in acid, may have driven his mother to tears, but they also led to the development of the first man-made fertiliser. This changed farming forever. Bigger harvests allowed cities to grow, and this in turn drove the Industrial Revolution. Lawes soon outgrew the manor house and began the world's oldest experiment, Broadbrook, which is still running today. This wheat field is divided into different plots to observe how differences in the levels of fertiliser and manure impact upon the crops and the soil. The vital knowledge gained from these long-running experiments has shaped the way we farm and has helped us to feed the world. In addition to his green fingers, Lawes also had another very British obsession, the weather. He wanted to know how it impacted crop yield as well as the spread of pests and diseases, so he built himself a weather station. Measurements have been taken every day at Rothamsted since 1853, one of the longest sets of weather data available in the UK. This has been vital to scientists in understanding and tracking climate change, including the greenhouse gases produced by farming. By the 1920s, all these long-term experiments had created mountains of data. Rothamsted employed mathematicians and statisticians to create entirely new ways to analyze this data, which eventually led to the creation of machine learning, algorithms, and artificial intelligence which underpin our current digital world. Whether it's your Spotify playlist, Google searches, or even NASA space missions. Whether they're pollinating or destroying our crops, insects play a huge role in farming. Perhaps then it's no surprise that Rothamsted's been following their movements quite closely. Set up in 1964, the network of 90 UK traps monitors the movements of pest species such as aphids and moths, as well as beneficial insects such as ladybirds. In total, it's tracked over 1,000 species and collected over 55 million individual insects. With biodiversity loss being a huge concern, the Rothamsted Insect Survey is vital in determining not only which insect species are in decline, but when and where those changes occur. During the 1960s and 70s, a range of pesticides were developed at Rothamsted based on pyrethrin, a naturally occurring chemical found in chrysanthemum flowers. Today, mosquito nets treated with pyrethroids are the only ones recommended by the World Health Organization and are one of our main tools in the international fight against malaria. In this century alone, they're thought to have prevented hundreds of millions of cases in Africa and have almost halved cases of the disease globally. We've long known that adding organic material such as manure to soils better improves its performance, but it wasn't until recently that we understood why. We discovered that the addition of carbon led soil microbes to excrete a sticky substance which clumps the soil around it, allowing for better transmission of water and air through the soil. Understanding how soils work will improve farming, but also help us better tackle issues such as drought, flooding, and climate change. In the 1980s, Rothamsted led the development of the first genetically modified crops. Our scientists' research helped pave the way for improved crops and foodstuffs, which are enjoyed by millions around the world. And right now, we're conducting Europe's first trials of gene-edited wheat. This might be the best thing since sliced bread. You probably know that brown bread is better for you, but most of us prefer to eat white. In 2020, we pinpointed the wheat gene responsible for dietary fiber in white flour, and now we can more than double the content. This high-fiber white flour makes a tasty loaf and should be available in your supermarkets within the next couple of years. So, bigger, better harvests, vital climate change data, Google searches, insect conservation, protection from malaria, digging up the secrets of soil, and healthier white bread. So, what will Rothamsted do next?